What's up, peeps? Thanks for joining me. My name is David Warren, and this is Day One Tech. Today, I got the new iPad Pro M4, new for 2024. Just gonna unbox it. My experience, this is the first time I've actually got an Apple product new from the Apple store. I did basically the whole experience with Apple. So I ordered it through the app. I used the Apple Pay. They sent me a QR code for the check-in and pickup. So when I got to the store, I just showed them the QR code and they had everything ready. I traded in. I got less than what I would get if I sold it privately, but it was easy, seamless. I was in and out just 15 minutes. It was real easy to get done. So the experience was real nice. Great people, great employees. So why did I go with the iPad Pro? And this is the 11-inch 256. So it's 11-inch 256. And the one I traded in was a 12.9. 256 that was the previous iPad Pro model, and before that one I had the iPad Mini. I really enjoyed the iPad Mini, but it wasn't able to keep up with my production, and they weren't coming out with a new like iPad Mini Pro. So I went and bought the 12.9. When I got the 12.9, it was heavy, it was big, and it didn't quite fit. It spent more time at home than out in the field with me when I was on my adventures. So when this one came out, I said maybe I'll upgrade to the 11-inch to make it a little easier to carry around, and it's lighter this year. So it's thinner and lighter. They moved the camera instead of to the top, to the side doing FaceTime or Zoom meetings. They put the new M4 chip in it, which is the fastest chip. The M4 is not in anything other than the iPad Pros. They're using a OLE screen, but there's like two of them layered on top of each other, so the colors are amazing. They're supposed to look amazing. When I was in the store, I did grab one of the models that they had on the floor, and it was nice and light, and it felt really good in my hands. So let's unbox it here. So the unboxing, it's real easy. You just have these tabs here that you pull that right there, and you pull that right there. That's it. They've really been reducing these boxes. So here we go. So let's take a look inside the box first. Inside the box, you got your paperwork. Inside the box, you get your paperwork. And it does come with this nice braided cable. And I heard two different things, so this is a nice surprise. This is the 11-inch with the black cord. So it does come with the cord to match the iPad inside the box, and then you get your power brick. If you want to get a power brick that gives more power, you can get one of those. This is kind of like the basic one, but you do get the brick and the cord. And that's all that's inside there. Inside this, another thing they changed to kind of reduce the waste this year is there are no more stickers. Let me know how you feel about that. Like, are you into the stickers? Are you gonna miss the stickers? Me? Nah, probably not so much. I have a whole bunch of stickers all over the place. I put them on a board on my wall, and I'm the only one that really sees it. So there you go. Now back to the pad here. Then the first thing I always say, and first thing I buy when I get a new piece of equipment, like a phone or a tablet, is a case. So I got one in mind that I'm gonna be purchasing. But this is it. All right, so it's got fingerprints on it, of course, but that's what happens. Oh, look at that. It's nice and thin. It's light. It's just about as thick as the USB-C port right there. You got your speakers, four speakers, one microphone. Now, as a heads up, if you have the pen 2, It does magnetically stick. You feel it does slide back and forth, but it's not supposed to be able to be used with this one, so I gotta get the new one. I do enjoy using the pen. Sometimes I draw with it, I edit. I use my iPad a lot for editing photos and editing videos. That's really the brunt work. So I'll carry it in my bag, and when I'm going somewhere or waiting, I'll pull up my iPad, and then I'm able to edit right on the iPad using LumaFusion. So it's definitely one of the tools that I use, and I've grown used to using it. And I missed that when I wasn't able to carry around my iPad with me because it was so big with that 12.9. So that's it right there. It's got the one camera now, and it's got a LiDAR sensor. I never use a LiDAR sensor. This flash is supposed to be so you can scan documents better, so it takes out all the shadows. But the camera, I've used it maybe 5 times. Sometimes I'm editing a video and then I just want to hurry up and grab a picture or a thumbnail. I can just use the tablet to take it right then, as opposed to using the camera, then transfer it. Just makes life a little easier. But yeah, that's it. That's really what it's about. It's the size. I like this form factor, and I'm going to really like the speed. But that's why I got the new iPad M4. It was really about the size and weight was the key features for me, being on the go and being able to have something that I could just pull out with a nice screen to edit with, and then, you know, when I'm in transit. So there you go. Do you have an iPad? Have you ever used one? Yeah. Have you tried editing on an iPad? I really enjoy it. All right. Thanks for watching this video. If you got any questions, hit me up in the comments. And until next video, remember, take care of each other. Peace out, and I will see you all soon.